automation can give you freedom. And in this video, I want to share with you 7 areas which you can automate if you're a digital coach, if you're a trainer or a consultant, so that you can free a lot of your time and you can maximize your efficiency in your business growth. I have just like 2 or 3 freelancers working for me, and I've been able to scale my business rapidly without many human components in the business because I have implemented automation at a level that very few people are implementing in this space. A lot of people have like basic websites, email automation, autoresponders, that's fine, but there's something deeper to this which I'm going to be sharing in this video. So stay till the end, take a lot of notes, and get blown away. Let's go and watch this.
Give it up for Siddharth Ratchasekar!
Hi there, Siddharth Ratchasekar here. Welcome to this video, and I'm going to talk to you about the 7 different things that you can automate in a knowledge business, in a digital coaching business. And there are different levels of automation. I'm going to give you how do you start from the most basic automation going into the most detailed level of automation. I'm going to give you the principles. So please take a lot of notes. And if you're watching this on YouTube or Facebook or whatever, just hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, stay notified, because I want you to stay connected with this kind of information that I keep rolling out on a time to time basis. So let's come into the first point, which is lead automation. How can you automate your leads? So, all of you would have heard of this concept called email autoresponders. It's the most basic form of automation. If somebody responds to your, comes on your landing page and they give their name and email, you can send them a whole sequence of emails for how many ever days that you want after they have signed up on your form. So email automation is the most basic form of automation that you can actually do whenever somebody registers for your lead magnet, whatever it may be. If you want to do a free webinar, or if you want to do like a free giveaway or a free ebook, you can send them a whole series of emails where you can nurture them even after that. There's one level deeper in this. You can also have multi-channel lead communication. Okay, all of you just type MCLC, multi-channel lead communication. When I say multi-channel, how I collect leads is not just the email ID, because email ID is just one of the options, or one of the channels, which is an important channel. But I'm also noticing the email open rates are going down, and there are other channels where people are able to get much better engagement, or I'm able to correspond to them in a much better way. So you can use WhatsApp groups. Like if somebody registers for my webinar, they get into a WhatsApp group, and then you have a whole reminder sequence over there. Two is you can use Facebook group. So after you've collected the lead, then you can automate a process by which they get into the Facebook group itself. Maybe have a thank you, like a button on your thank you page. And the third thing that you can do is you can also have SMS automation. Collect people's mobile numbers, and SMS open rates are much higher than any other platform that I've seen. It's even more than chatbots, provided you have the right messaging in place. Okay. So as a part of lead automation, you can do email automation, SMS automation, and group automation. So all of this would come under the lead automation segment itself, and this is the first out of the 7 different things that you can automate. Let's come to the second one, sales automation. Now sales automation can happen in a few ways. How can you automatically get somebody to buy your product? That's what I mean by sales automation. And you can have it again in a few different processes that you can implement this. The most easiest way is to do an automated webinar. Like if any of you go to my this particular link here, which is sids.co/formula. Okay, this is an example I'm just going to show you. If you go to this link, let me just hide this. If you go to sids.co/formula, it is an automated webinar that is working 24/7. And 24/7, I'm getting sales through this particular training. So you can have an automated sales funnel that is happening through an automated webinar. That is the first way. The second sales automation that you can do is I'm using a tool called Webinar Jam. Okay, now on Webinar Jam, if somebody, I use both Zoom and Webinar Jam. Webinar Jam has some really cool features when it comes to tagging. So when somebody comes to my email, comes to my webinar, they get tagged as an attendee. If somebody misses the webinar, they get tagged as someone who's missed. If somebody leaves the webinar early, they get tagged on somebody who's missed the webinar. And if someone has stayed till the end of the webinar, after a particular point, maybe after 1 hour duration, which I've set a rule over there, they get tagged as somebody who's attended the webinar till the end. So for each of these 4 different segments of lists, I have different sales automation going over there. So the people who attended my webinar, I give them some goodies. If somebody has bought my product, they won't get this kind of notifications. Those people who attended the webinar but did not buy, they would get a whole series of communication where it is, you know, I give them another opportunity to buy. Same thing, if somebody missed my webinar, I would bring them to the automated webinar. If somebody left, came after or stayed till the end, till a particular point, I would give them some gifts. Okay. And what is the other segment which I mentioned? People who left early, people who missed, people who attended. Yeah, and people who attended till the end. Yeah. So these are the different things that you can do when it comes to sales automation, how you can drive sales based on this. And also you can do sales automation by chasing those people who came on your landing page, who came on the product purchase page but did not buy. You can even remarket them. That also would come under sales automation. Okay. Now, if this is going over your head, don't worry. Okay. Once you come into my system, you'll be learning all of this step by step, but I'm just giving you an overall idea of how this really works. What is the other thing you can automate? Number three is you can, automation, but it is more to do with data aggregation that you can see over here. You can see a data aggregation. This is a concept that I learned from my mentor. And it is basically what I shared with you earlier, but let's go deeper into this. Now, how can you aggregate data? Data aggregation is the process of you segmenting your audience and your lists in such a way that you can have different communication for them based on different stages that they are in your journey. Okay, so you have to look from cold market to warm market to becoming a customer. Okay, from warm to hot, hot to customer. And from customer, you have different levels of customers. Okay. So I have a whole data aggregation sequence where if somebody becomes a lead, they get tagged as a webinar lead. If someone clicks on any of the links in my web, in my emails, they get tagged as someone who's really, somebody who's really serious about it. Okay. Because they've engaged in my emails. They've not just left the email unopened. Okay. So those people have unopened my emails. After some time, they automatically get deleted from the whole system itself. Okay, there are some people who just put some fake emails and stuff. Then what happens is the next one is, so we have the cold emails, we have the engaged emails. Then I run people through a form actually. It's a type form, it is a quiz. In fact, you guys can actually try this out. If you're watching this, there is a link. I'll just send you this link. I'm just creating this link. Just bookmark this link and you can go later and try it. If you go to sids.co/qualify below here, it is a qualification form to know whether people are ready for digital coaching or not. And if somebody goes through this qualification form and if they're qualified, I tag them as a separate segment in my data aggregation list itself. So we have cold lead, we have engaged leads, we have qualified leads, and then when they come to my webinar, we have attendees. They're like the hot leads because they have actually engaged with me. And then I have customers. So on the customers, I have 3-4 different segments. Level 1 customers, level 2 customers, level 3 customers. So if anyone buys my product on any of my links, they automatically get tagged into whichever stage that they are in. And the best part is everything, whatever I'm sharing with you right now happens in complete God mode, G-O-D-M-O-D-E. I'm not doing anything physically. I'm not doing anything manually. And this has saved like hours or hundreds and thousands of hours of effort if I had to manually do these tasks. Okay, towards the end, I'm going to share with you 2 tools which you can use to automate. Okay, so data aggregation is how do you aggregate your leads data into these different segments. Okay, number 4 is you can automate your advertising. On Facebook ads, you have some rules. I'm not sure many people have tried this, but those of you who want to explore this, you can do that. You can actually set like different ad sets when you're running ads. So for example, you're running a campaign and you're targeting, that campaign is to get more people to come into your webinar. And when you're getting them to come to your webinar, the structure that I share, which is my fragmental Facebook ads method that I share inside my course, you have to have like multiple strands of ads. So under a campaign, you need to have at least 5 to 10 different ad sets, each ad set targeting a different target segment, and under each ad set have multiple ads, a combination of different media, a combination of video, image, and other media, if you have, like, you want to bring them to a blog or whatever. So when you have this fragmented Facebook advertising, when you have like multiple ads, Let's say, for example, you're spending 1,000 rupees per day. That 1,000 rupees should be distributed to at least 10 to 20 ads. That's how Facebook algorithm can actually bring it and make it work for you, okay? So there are rules in Facebook ads. You can set rules like if the cost per lead goes above a particular level, the ad should automatically switch off. After waiting for 2 days, 3 days or whatever, you can actually set those rules. So once you are able to put in like a cap on ad automation, the kind of level of control that you can have on your cost per lead is, it's insane. Like I mentioned, very few people do this. But those actually go deep into learning this and implementing this. They are the ones who will be getting like 3x, 5x, 10x return on ad spends, ROAS. Okay, so ad automation is also possible. Let's come to number five, is you can do reporting automation. I love this part the most in my system, which I've customized for myself. So how have I automated my reports? See, you have reports which are already there on Facebook. Okay, if you're running Facebook ads or Google ads. And what I've done is I've also customized a dashboard for myself, which is customized to my business, sitting on Google Sheets. So if anyone buys my product, any product of mine, their data goes into my Google Sheet. It totals up how much revenue is being generated, how much did they pay, based on whichever payment processor they paid with, whether it's InstaMojo, Razorpay, PayPal, Stripe, I have all these different payment processors. Then on a real-time dashboard, like right now, if I open my dashboard, I'll be able to know what is my exact number of sales until today, real-time, what is my total ad spends, and what is my CPA, my cost per acquisition on my level one program, what is my lead to level one conversion ratio, what is my level one to level two conversion ratio, what's my level two to level three conversion ratio, everything real-time, instant, at the same second. It gets updated. Now, when you're able to see your entire business on a single line report like this for every month, I can even go deeper and dig into data if I want. But once you're able to go deep, once you're able to see a single line report like this, it gives you a kind of control like never before. You can make decisions like on the fly. Like I know what is my CPA for Facebook, what's my CPA for Google, cost per acquisition for a customer. And I can track that on a pattern monthly basis. Then I can see, okay, if it's CPA versus Facebook and Google, if it's going to be Google, what kind of revenues have come out of Google alone? What kind of revenues have come from Facebook alone? And how many have upgraded from one to the next, depending on where they're coming from? So this is reporting automation. And if this is again going above your head, don't worry. You have to get started. And there's so much more to this game that you don't know. But if you get into this, it's going to open up a whole new dimension to you even running and building and scaling a business. Okay, you can only scale if you're able to implement this. Okay, number six is customer support bot. This is another automation which is very important. Okay. If anyone is logged into my learning management system, on the bottom right, I have a chat bot where I've preloaded more than 200 to 300 questions that people ask regularly. And I've pre-written those questions and I've pre-written the answers. In some cases, I've pointed them to the resource inside my community itself where they can get the answer. So customer support automation has saved me so much of time with, you know, over 7,000 people in my community. I mean, the kind of emails that I used to get before this was insane. Like I do have a community manager, but what ends up happening is personally, I used to be responding to a lot of emails on the same questions being repeated again and again and again. But now with the introduction of the chatbot, which is called the Freedom Bot, which people will be able to see only if they're logged into the system, that has opened up a whole new dimension to them being able to get the support answer specifically on the question that they want, and it's instant answer. Some of the answers I've just typed it out and they get the answer then and there. In some cases I point them to a resource or a video or a download or whatever. So you can even automate your customer support, okay? And finally, number seven is you can automate your messenger bots. And messenger bots you can have on your website, like on my blog, I have a messenger bot. And even on my Facebook page, I have a messenger bot. Okay, I have a chat bot which is sitting on this link. In fact, if any of you want to experiment my messenger bot, okay, you can just go and go and check out this link, which is asksids.com. Okay, if you go to asksids.com, it'll take you to my Facebook messenger. And just go and type the words DTC over there. Okay, go to askthis.com and just type DTC. And when you type DTC, what will end up happening is you will see that, I'm going to walk you through a 21-day challenge, digital tribe challenge, and help you build growing your influence using videos and stuff like that. So even that is a chatbot sequence that I've programmed inside my ManyChat system here. Okay. So anyway, I've given a lot of information in this. And if you want to get started inside my community, this is the link. sys.co/formula. Okay. Let me center this. Yeah. So if you want to learn how to build a super profitable automated knowledge business by implementing all these 7 different automation ideas that I've just shared with you, you have to start at some point. Okay. Before you come into the high level automation, you need to have your own system in place. So go through this, this particular training. It's a 45 minutes onboarding orientation video. Watch that video, take action, come inside my community. You have lifetime membership for whatever price point that I mentioned over there. You have lifetime access to it. And as you go through the journey, you'll be able to build something like this for yourself. Okay. So what I'm here to tell you is that the future of business is automation. The future of a knowledge business is about getting into these granular level automation implementation that you need to do, which can save you a lot of time, energy, and which is the only thing that can help you scale. And trust me, the more human components you have in a system, you'll have lesser scalability there. But if you're able to bring a human component that can actually follow, it's like Iron Man, you know, there has to be man plus machine. If it's only men, it won't really work. So have the Iron Man thought process for you to really make this work for you. Okay. So I'm going to be signing off. If you found this video useful, please share your comments below. Please hit the like button. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so that you get notified on the future updates that I do. And more importantly, take this seriously. This is not something to be taken lightly. If you truly want freedom, you have to get into automation. All the best. Take care and keep watching out for my next video.